We never live cause we stay fly. I'ma be a bitch for life. If they try you. Thank you for stopping on my channel, Styles Pro Grow, where we grow our techniques and confidence in skill building in this cosmetology field. Today, I am going to give you as detailed as I possibly can, because that's all I do, all my videos, how and why I use this cap to create that look that you saw, which was the mullet mohawk or what have you. And I really enjoy it. Now, I like using this cap because it's already, I want to say, parted out, quote unquote, and we have the cap pushed back 9 inches above to start the hairline, because we know, you know why we use 8 to 9 inches? Because the hairline and the chin is about 9 or 8 inches apart from each other. And if you position that cap right on your mannequin head, I mean, you will have a perfect fit all the time. When you're laying the tracks, try not to lay them on the elastic band that's within the track, within the cap. Lay it just right behind it, right there, you know what I mean? And you'll still be able to make the cap tighter to make it an even more secure fit. And just placing the tracks at a straight across angle, I'm definitely going to show you how to place the tracks. And yes, press the first roll of the 27 piece hair out, because when I tell you, it is so much easier to lay those tracks when you press it out like that. Look how straight the tracks is, right? And now boom, you take them apart and you lay them, and you will see the style being created. And sometimes you can even lay the tracks a little further, because again, we're stacking them on top, a little further apart from each other, because again, we're stacking them on top of each other. But for me, because I like to shape and I like to have control of the density or what have you, I kind of make the cap, I kind of lay the hair a little dense so that I'll have room to shape it down to make it look more natural and beautiful. And that's what you see me doing here. Like I said, you just lay the tracks in a straight line, and as you're laying them and you're laying the next track a little bit further forward than the last track, it kind of creates a natural fall around the area, which will be around the ear, around the area on the sides. And I'm telling you, it gives a perfect blend, a perfect look when you lay the tracks like this, and you're using this cap as opposed to the mesh dome cap to create this quick wig mohawk mullet. That's what I'm creating, a quick wig. I call it a quick wig, or it's referred to as a quick wig, because we're creating it with bonding glue, and it takes less time than creating it with a thread if you were doing it hand. Now, we know a machine threaded wig can be made in 30 minutes when you have good training. But for me, I really like to make the quick wigs, you know, because sometimes you don't want to create a long line of thread, and it'll be difficult to create a wig like this on the machine. These wigs usually last about 4 to 6 months. Yes, 4 to 6 months. You can shampoo them once a month, you know, or when they build up or what have you, but they last 4 to 6 months. Like, this is the best way to create a custom wig. Like, I'm sorry for saying the word like, but like, for real, okay? This is the best way to create a custom wig. It fits the head like a glove, even better than a machine-made wig. I'm just going to say that. We don't have to use any closures, so it's completely glueless. It allows you to play with short styles, which you get more diverse looks when you rock in short styles than when you're rocking long styles. Because when a long style, you see how I got that in there? And it's laying nice and flat. And yes, I'm still going to shave it down once I get everything in and all that good stuff. And we're going to work on the other side, which, dang, I forgot. I did not record filling in the other side, but here we go. You get the gist of it. If you're following me and you're a beginner, I'm sorry that I'm skip or did not record the other laying the other tracks. But if you are a hairstylist, you got an amazing imagination, so you could just about follow what I did and where I am now. And again, those lines that are in the cap, they help create
the outline of where your sides will be and where the middle of the mohawk mullet will be. And now we're in the middle of the mohawk mullet, and I definitely want to put a pop of color in there. So I put it in a bang and I put it in the back where the mullet part is. And listen, when you're laying the tracks in the back, you want to lay it in like a soft smile, or I want to say a soft smile, for the simple fact it, when you place it and you use the soft smile, the hair kind of falls over to the sides a little bit, which blends it all together when you're doing the cut to create the finished look of this mullet mohawk quick wig. Now, these wigs run about $200 to create them, and you supply the hair. I supply the cap because I know what cap I like to use, but you supply the hair and it's for $200. If I supply the hair, it's an extra cost depending on the quality of hair. And yes, you can use virgin quality hair to make a quick wig with for $200, and then get you some virgin quality hair. The wig will last so much longer. I don't want to say it will last longer than a handmade, machine-made wig if you're using thread, because you can, obviously, if you're making it with a machine, the machine attaches it very well. You know what I mean? But it's something about making it with this bonding glue, ladies and gentlemen, that it just lays so flat, so secure. It seems like it creates a almost like it's so light. It's so light, and it's light because we're not sandwiching two tracks together to create a track placement. We're using one track at a time. We're putting space in the middle. It's just light. My clients who have the personal summers, my clients who are battling cancers or alopecia in some form, they say this is the best wig that they ever had. And I will say, because I made this wig for myself, it is so lightweight, it doesn't even feel like it's on your head. I just don't know. I mean, it doesn't feel like it's on your head. It doesn't look like a wig when you wear it, because the way that it's created is so super flat. Yes, you can create this wig, a quick wig, with a frontal or a closure or anything like that. And I just don't know. I mean, this is like the optimal way to create a custom wig in 2024. The turnaround time is, because sometimes I make the wigs on the client's head, you know what I mean? And so they can leave the appointment with the wig, you know what I mean? It's just like that. You do the foundation care, meaning any scalp treatments that you're going to do for the alopecia or anything like that. Now we're in the front part of laying the tracks, and you see we're still using the soft smile, soft C, or however you want to put it, to create a circular pattern in the head. Because as we're building this front, it's creating a circular pattern where we can close it off in a circle when we get a little further back in the high crown area, okay? But like I was saying, my clients love this. This is a lightweight. I created this wig for the workshop that I did. I wanted to look cute and trendy and you know, something like that. And definitely I wasn't going to cut my hair to look like this. You know what I mean? I'm growing it out and loving on my curls more, my natural curls more. So, and yes, I like to wear wigs. And to have a strong, natural, curly foundation for a wig is just absolutely outstanding. You can sew this down where you don't have to take it off, or you can take it off and put it on a foam dome mannequin head at night to keep the shape, however you please. But this sucker is light, extremely light, and it's flat, and it's undetectable, and you can do a great cut with it. Yeah, you can do a great cut with the machine-made wig, but to do a great shortcut, the tracks have to be extremely close, right? But you can't put tracks super close when you're doing a machine-made wig. You don't want to put tracks super close when you're doing a machine-made wig, because one, it takes too long. Two, it may make the cap a little smaller than you want it to be. Like, it loses the shape of the initial measurements. It's just all of that gets to come into play when you're using a machine-made wig to create caps. When you're using a machine to create a wig on a dome cap, when you're putting too many tracks on that cap, it tends to shrink the cap even more, and it messes up the measurements. There's no shrinking happening here. No type of shrinking happening here. Wherever we use the T-pins to stretch this particular cap that I use, I love using this cap when creating the mohawk. I do use the dome cap also for this type of quick wig, but I like using this particular cap because it has adjustable bands inside of it where you can even make it even more snug. You know, it's undeniable that this is the best process to do when creating a wig. It's just truly, truly undeniable. And I truly, truly love using this process when creating a quick wig. And it's so easy and versatile to do. And you don't have to use high grade quality hair. And you don't have to use low grade quality hair. I mean, actually, to tell you the truth, you can use any quality hair, even pack synthetic. And I really like making quick wigs with pack synthetic hair. Even though this is a human brand that I'm using, you know I got to use my Empire. I don't play about Empire. That's the only brand I use when it comes to bonding hair in. And some people even ask me to sew Empire hair in. But that's a different topic for a different YouTube. Man, if y'all still here, thank y'all. Thank y'all for being here. If you're still here in this video right now at this moment, I'm just going to pull the plastic off so that the glue can completely dry. At this moment, if this was a unit for a client, I would just sit this unit, after I peeled the plastic off, I would sit this unit inside of the dryer just to make sure that all that glue is completely dry. And sometimes it does get tedious to pull the saran wrap off the bottom, but just take your time. Take your time and pull as much as you possibly can pull off. Pull as much as you possibly can pull off. It will take a little bit of time. Sometimes the glue dries so fast, especially that 30 second, that it adheres. So we got it down and we got it off. And I'm just going to you're about to watch me do a rough cut. I'm doing a rough cut and I'm going to use shears. That's why I'm wetting the hair down. And believe me, the integrity of the adhesive that I use, the 30-second bonding glue, does not be affected because I'm using the water. It really does not be affected. I really like wetting the extensions down when I'm using my disposable disposable razor, because it lets that razor glide down that hair like butter. And you're just shaving it off and you see what you're creating. You know what I mean? You really see what you're creating. And I really enjoy using the disposable feather razor in order to shape down this 27 piece kind of, I guess you can call it a 27 piece mohawk mullet or what have you, because it's a mullet, but it's not a mullet, and it's a mohawk, but it's not a mohawk. So, you know, mohawk mullet, that's how we're going to say it for now. And I enjoy shaping these units. Like, that's where our extensions get identity. That's where we really put the signature, if you're wearing them or if you're creating them, the real signature of a extension job or a custom wig is how you shape it. Okay. And I'm just doing a rough shaping on this particular quick wig, because I just want to get some of the hair off. Because if I put the wig on my head, like I said, I'm making it for myself. But if I put the wig on my head, the details that the mullet need in the back, I wouldn't be able to do that. So I'm kind of doing the details in the back and the details in the front, rough cutting the details in the front. And you're also going to see me continue to shape this unit on my head in this video. So give it a minute. And just feeling, I like to, you see how I have my hands following the razor, because I'm able to feel, is that enough? Is it too bulky? Should I take some more off? Yeah, I could take some more off. I need this. It's this certain feeling that I'm looking for that I know will give me a natural look. Now, as you see, I'm going in an angle to the left or the right when I'm shaping down the mullet. And that's just to give that V cut. You know what I mean? If you're shaping to one side, going to the right, shape to the other side, going to the left, and it allows the mullet to be shaped into a V. And you'll watch that being formed as you watch the video. If you are still in this video right now, thank you so, so much for being so patient and enjoying my content on my YouTube channel. You are on Styles Pro Grow, where we grow our confidence and our skill set in creating beautiful styles to service our clients, or creating beautiful styles that clients can go back and show their hairstylist, hey, I saw this on YouTube. Look, can you do this on me? I'm just trying to be the answer. And that's what I call myself on TikTok, the answer. The answer to your beauty needs, be it clothes, extensions, wigs, lashes, accessories, whatever you need. Oh, thank you for still being in this video, still watching this video at this very point. Now, you see me creating the layers in the back. Movement, baby. Movement. If you want to create movement when using a razor, you must move the hair as you razor it. That has been my number one thing to do when shaping weave with a feather razor. I move the hair as I shape the weave. And that, you see, now you see that point I was getting at? That, you know, that's that point that gives it that look when you put it on your head. My God, it's so beautiful already. So we're going to go into the bang area and get that bang together. And I definitely want it to look like a bowl cut kind of in the front with a splash of color coming from the bottom. That was the reason for the color in the front. Just a splash of color coming from the bottom. I almost believe I did add a little bit too much color at the end of it. But as you saw in the beginning picture, it still turned out very cute with the amount of color that we did add, because I did not take any out. I did not take any out. And you can see that the color is is up under the black hair. So it's just intended to be like a peekaboo of color. And I absolutely love it. I'm going to continue to shape this, and it's going to fall into the next videos up. It's going to fall into me actually shaping it and continuing to shape it on my head. And I'll come back when I feel that, you know, maybe I need to explain what's going on in the video. But thus far, you see what's happening. We are creating a fire quick wig mullet mohawk. I'm trying to tell you. And it's commonly known as a removable quick weave. If you were to put that in the search of the YouTube, you will see other stylists that create removable quick weaves. And the term that I like to use is quick wig, because you can look at that. You see? It kind of give that bowl look. Oh my, that bowl look. You know how we like that boy cut? Oh my God. It's so beautiful, even on the mannequin. But I call it the quick wig because it's quick and easy, and it's quick, light, convenient to create. That's why I like to call it the quick wig. And oh my goodness, that cut is in there. The cut is in there. I'm telling you, the cut is in there. But we still got to get more detail cutting. Like I said, this is the rough cut. So the next coming up segment or what have you would be me shaping it on my head. And enjoy that. And I'll come back in if I feel that I need more details.
Thank you.
we're going to get into the curling of the unit. Now, in the back, I definitely wanted some loose curls just so we can add some volume and you can see the different lengths that's in the back and things of that nature. As you can see that around my ears is more defined since I took it off my head. The bowl look is in. You can see that bowl cut in the front. I mean, I really, really enjoyed creating this unit. It's very easy, very simple to create. It is so simple to add this to your menu as a hairstylist and or to add this as a service request from your hairstylist. Like if you were a client, I would maybe have the cap already if you want to introduce this to your hairstylist and maybe even get the saran wrap because that's about the only thing that you would need and probably even the bundles that you want to use. So bringing the saran wrap, the cap, and the bundles that you want to use to your hairstylist to introduce this to your hairstylist as a service you would like to try. Don't forget to request that you get a foundation service with this. That means you should get a shampoo, deep conditioner, and your hair should be braided back. If you have an abundant amount of hair, braided back in 6 to 8 braids. If you have a fairly, like not too thick amount of hair, maybe a 5 to 6 braids to the back, put the saran wrap on, put the cap on, and create the full quick weave as usual. Because that's basically what we're creating, a full quick weave, okay? But we're doing it on a special cap, and we're using the saran wrap to be the protector so that the glue will not get to on our foundation braids and get stuck to our hair and cause any type of breakage. And once you remove the saran wrap, boom, you got you a quick wig. And you just made you a quick little wig, you know what I mean? And you can do this at home for yourself. Get you a mannequin stand, get you a mannequin head that measures about 21 inches. Get you a cap, get you some T-pins, get all of that. Get a cap, get you some T-pins, get you some scissors, if you can't do all that, go ahead and introduce this to your hairstylist that you trust instead of trying to take it in your own hands anyway. Go back to the salon. Something to introduce to your stylist that you trust. Because most of us, when I say us, I mean African-American women. I can care less if you get offended because I'm saying most of us, meaning African-American women. We find it difficult to have our hair out on a daily basis because it requires so much love and attention to act manageable. So we would prefer to get a nice shampoo, deep conditioning braid down and wear somebody else's hair, okay? And that's what we like to do. And when we wear somebody else's hair, we want it to look good. So if you're wearing somebody else's hair and you want it to look good, make sure you're shaping it up right. It's done by a professional. And that's what it is. I know it's abundant amount of hairstylists, YouTube artists, or whatever that are not licensed cosmetologists. And they know how to rock some hair. Would I trust them? Not really, because I'm not going to say not really. No, I don't trust you if you're not licensed. I'm sorry. It's like a hazing to get licensed, to go through the, and I'm going to call it grueling, because any licensed cosmetologist know that going through cosmetology school is grueling. Okay. The patience that you need to have an exercise, to have to deal with the level of information that you have to learn and practice, also deal with how to create the confidence to create your own business that you can stand alone and not be in a commissioned salon. That's another thing that you have to create when you're a cosmetologist. And that's why I respect only cosmetologists when it comes to hair, because they created the confidence to get out there and be their own boss or work as a team on a commission in a commission salon, but they're out there. They're not in their house hiding. Yes, you are hiding if you're in your house. You don't trust your ability to sustain outside in the public. I don't care what you're talking about. I'm saving more money. Who in the world Forget it. I ain't even finna go there. That's all right. That's all right. It is what it is. To each his own. I only trust cosmetologists that stand in salons or salon suites. Licensed. I must see your license. And that's just me. And that's what I demand. Because I'm definitely not finna make no, let no gynecologist, quote unquote, look at my kitty cat and he not really licensed. Your hair on your head is just as special as your private parts, if not even more special, because it's what everyone sees when they look at you. So you got to make sure it's in the right hands. Okay, that's why you should go to a licensed cosmetologist. And if you go to a licensed cosmetologist and you want to introduce them or ask them to do this quick wig for you, make sure you take with you a box of saran wrap, a mesh dome cap, and a couple of bundles of your favorite hair that you like to use. They should be able to create a full classic quick weave on you, and it should come out phenomenal because it's made on your head, and it should last. I mean, the construction of it. Hopefully you go back once a month to get your foundation braids redid so you can continue the healthy hair journey up under there. But the construction of it lasts at least 4 to 6 months. And mind you, you're paying a minimal fee of up to about $200. I know mine started at $200 to create this, and it does not include hair. Up to about $200 or more. You know what I mean? And if you're introducing this to your cosmetologist, aka hairstylist that you trust in the salon, at least pay them the price of a full quick weave, which may be a little cheaper than the quick wig, but that's actually what you're getting, a full classic quick weave. And you're just able to remove it. And as simple as that. Now you see, after the curls and me bumping it a little bit, them layers are coming out. That look is together, honey. The look is looking. I'm trying to tell you. The look is looking, and I love every minute of it. Oh, look at those curls. You see that look? This is art. Y'all must not forget, the hair is a form of expression. It is art, baby. And everyone is not an artist, just like everyone can't paint. Yea, though they want to in some form or way. And guess what? It's somebody who like it. Yep, it sure is. But baby, didn't she come out pretty? Oh my gosh, she came out so pretty, y'all. She's so pretty. You can see the little peekaboo of color in the bang. Just a little peekaboo of color. She's so pretty. I'm going to give y'all a close-up of her. Let me putting the finishing touches. If you made it to this video right now, through all my encouraging speaking and motivation and things like that, I want to say bless you. And I want to say I hope you subscribe, because there's more videos to come. As long as I'm breathing, a video will drop every Friday at 12 midnight. For real, for real. And now this is a beautiful, removable, quick weave mohawk mullet. Check it out. Right? Because you see it. You see it. All those details. Oh my goodness. The peekaboo of color. The nice sideburns. The way that it's shaped. The curls. Listen. Yeah, we got a lot going on with it. Because we got a lot going on with this mohawk mullet, man. Removable quick wig. You see it? It's so beautiful. Shiny black always do us good. I'm going to make another one for myself. It's going to have one of those deep bangs. Or I may make one where it's just this bowl cut that you see here. The whole entire wig is a bowl cut. But for now, boom. We got the sideburns in there. She's shaped to perfection around the ears and in the nape area. Them curls is curling. You can see the layers, and they're going to stay because of the layers. That's the trick to get curls to really stay. Cut some layers in there. I mean, she's just beautiful. Wouldn't you agree? Thank y'all for watching my channel. God bless you. I appreciate y'all for watching my channel. Be blessed.